Good morning, St. John family. I have to leave this Sunday morning at 6 a.m. in order to serve as chaplain on a retreat, but I didn't want to leave without giving some encouragement to you after this chaotic week in our nation. You know, with all the vitriol and the violence swirling around our American cities, the sentiments expressed by Jeremiah in today's first reading may resonate with you. Jeremiah had this to say of the mob mentality going on in his day. "I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side, denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps we will trap him, then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him." End of quote. So Jeremiah was on edge, afraid of what they might do next to try to trap him. And so many people in our society today are on edge. They live in fear and do not feel the freedom to express themselves and talk things out of fear of the mob mentality that has taken over public discourse. And when that happens, when we don't give one another the freedom, the respect, and the room to work things out openly because of fear of character assassination or losing our job or losing our friends or what it may mean for the reputation or even safety of our own family members, and we feel forced to be silent, those unresolved feelings fester inside and they breed further resentment and even deeper division. This is why threats and violence are never the answer. Going further down that road of might makes right, which is the path many in our country have taken, swirls into more intensified violence, and if not stopped, eventually leads to totalitarian rule and enslavement by whoever is mightier, rather than whoever is on the side of true justice, true peace, true freedom, and the common good. The first step to overcoming not just racial division, but also political division, family division, every sort of division, is mutual understanding. You know, reach out to your neighbors and listen to one another. That's what we wanted to encourage when we posted on our Facebook page the 3-minute video of a black brother in the Lord, Basil Hampton, and I, describing what led to our afternoon discussion with one another. So we wanted to encourage people to talk to one another about our fears and our hopes. And I think that more often than not, what you'll find if you do that is that we are all desirous of the very same things: true justice, peace, freedom, and the common good. There is, however, a common enemy to these things, and that enemy is not each other. The enemy ultimately is not the people who disagree with you or some politician or some group of politicians. The enemy is not the people of another race or age or sex or political party. Believe it or not, the enemy is not even those who are complicit in the violence of these times, whether that violence comes in the form of brutality by corrupted cops or in the form of riots and mobs who destroy livelihoods and endanger lives. The only enemy, ultimately, is the one you'll hear Jesus refer to in the gospel. Jesus said, "Do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna." Back in Jesus' time, people were afraid of the Roman Empire or Herod and his underlings or the zealots who fought against them. But Jesus is trying to wake people up to the real and ultimately only enemy, the accuser, known as Satan or the devil. He is the one who can kill soul and body in Gehenna. And he is the sower of division, whose sole intent is the destruction of the one human race. As we saw in the emblematic story of the temptation of Adam and Eve by the serpent, the evil one has been working to destroy the human family from the get-go by getting us to blame one another, by sowing lies and half-truths, accusation and pride, so that we begin pointing the finger at everyone else that God has called us to love, instead of the great deceiver, pointing at the great deceiver. And the great lie that has kept his works hidden is the lie that the devil doesn't exist as a personal force of evil. You know, let's make a ridiculous caricature of him with horns and a pitchfork so that people think he's just some fabrication or construct of the imagination. You know, Pope Francis has denounced that heresy time and time again. The Holy Father has warned us about the devil's wiles and how he sets us against each other. So instead of recognizing Satan as the mastermind behind all this evil, we paint misguided people who have fallen for his lies, or people who are enslaved mentally and or spiritually, as the enemy. When Jesus, the Good Shepherd, had laid down his life to save those very people as well. So let's open our eyes, folks. If you believe that there are personal spiritual beings who are working for your good and my good, the greatest of whom is God, of course, who is love itself, then there's no reason for you not to believe in fallen personal spiritual beings who are working against our good and orchestrating all the evil in the world. But if we don't realize their existence, then guess who we're going to blame and demonize for all that is evil in the world? Not demons, but each other, which then makes peace impossible. We were not meant to live in fear of one another. We were meant to live in love of one another. So you'll hear Jesus say in today's gospel, fear no one. Instead, love one another. We have to understand that the road to mutual understanding, to justice and to peace, and to the love of one's neighbor is one that can never be forced. You can never legislate love. There is no coercion in love. You can't force people not to be racist. You can't force people to be more compassionate or to be more considerate of the poor. And if you try to force people to do that, then hearts will be even more hardened and embittered because they feel that they have no choice in the matter. There is no true change of heart there. That's why Jesus never coerces but invites. So do not give in to evil. Do not give in to all the lies and deceit of the evil one. Do not give in to the mob mentality and the sower of division that's behind all of it. Call the deceiver out, rebuke him, and dedicate yourself wholeheartedly to the path Jesus laid out for us. The one who perseveres to the end in that way, in that truth, and in that life will be saved. And our food for the journey is Jesus, who gives himself to us in the Eucharist. Have a great Mass.